it comes on this glorious day, this day when African Americans bring together not 100,000, which is what they initially hoped for, but 250,000 people, and show the country and the world the possibility of multiracial action. But without the mouse, there is no speech. Because after Birmingham, the civil rights leaders are thinking, what do we do with this? We've unleashed this genie. They had no idea that people were as hot to trot as they were. And so suddenly the people are leading them. Right before the march, when King's getting the final round of suggestions, Y.T. Walker says to him, don't do the eye of the genie. It's trite. It's a cliche. You've used it too many times already. Mahalia Jackson had heard him give that speech, the I Have a Dream refrain, in Detroit 3 months earlier. And so, as King is winding down, she says, she shouts, tell him about the dream, Martin. Tell him about the dream. King put his text to the left, and in his demeanor, changed from a lecturer to a preacher. And Jones turned to the person next to him and said, those people don't know it, but they're about to go to church. And then King says,
so even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream.
But that speech means nothing without the context that makes it possible. And King was a great man because he stood at the head of a great movement, and that great movement was made of large numbers of people. But in terms of a global speech, this is a speech that works as well for the Shia of Bahrain as it does for the Roma in the Czech Republic. And it translates easy. Its themes are universal.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
And so to remember him as the man, not who got rid of racism, which is they sometimes try and make that leap, but the man who gives the most eloquent articulation of the last great moral moment for which there is a consensus. That's the person that they want to remember. The argument I make in the book, and the argument I put to you, is that history is of course about what we remember, but it's also about what we choose to forget. The words of Frederick Douglass, power concedes nothing without a demand. It never has, and it never will. And so I do hope that at the end of this, you go on demanding, and that you work with Simon and other organizations to make that work real. But I know a change gonna come.